Spin version 3 is out and it comes jam-packed with new features and improvements that was all built from community feedback. Spin 3 is an open source tool built on top of Docker that now makes it even easier for you to self-host your applications. It also stands out as one of the only tools that allows you to have 100% replication across all your environments from development to production, including if you collaborate with users on macOS, Linux, and Windows. So one of the most exciting features of Spin 3 is the ability to be able to create and provision servers right from your command line. So looking at our example, we have any sort of Windows, Linux, or Mac workstation can run Ansible through Docker, and we provide a simple configuration file where you can provide your API key for your host like Hetzner and just run a simple command of spin provision. And what that command will do is it will communicate out to the API and it will create the server for us, wait for it to come online, and then it will go through and configure all of our users and their SSH keys, configure a secure firewall, and then harden the server for best security practices. The only thing that you need to do is just set the API key, run the command, and Spin will do all the heavy lifting for you. Once we have our server created, we want to have zero downtime deployments with GitHub Actions. And one of the biggest challenges that we had with GitHub Actions was creating an easy experience for users to upload and manage their secrets. Well, thankfully in Spin 3, we created the spin configure command. So in this case, we're going to run spin configure GHA, which stands for GitHub Actions, and then the environment, and it will automatically look into our environment variable file and configure it in a way where it will securely upload to GitHub Actions for deployments. The best thing is that this does not require any special GitHub plan. This will work on free and private repositories, and you can use it on as many projects as you'd like. Now, there are some people who even want an easier process, and that's where we created the spin deploy command. Now, this was available in version 2, but we finely tuned this and expanded this even more, where it's easy for you to work with your application on any host, run a spin deploy command, which will use the Docker file to create a Docker image on a local registry. It will establish a secure SSH tunnel to your server and then have your server pull that image from your local machine without any downtime. Now, these are all exciting releases, but the biggest thing is we are staying true to where you can run your application on any host. The API integrations that we're offering in Spin version 3 will all be through DigitalOcean, Vulture, and Hetzner. These are world-leading VPS providers, but even if you choose to host with somebody else, all you need to do is just have that server online and you can make a connection and Spin will work with it. Let me show you an example how this works. So let's create a Laravel application with Spin. I'm gonna show you how easy this is. We're gonna do Spin New and then our template. I'm just gonna show you the Laravel Pro template. This is gonna have everything in it. And then let's just call our app My Laravel App. And what this is going to do is it's going to use Docker and it's going to ask us a bunch of questions on what we want to use, what do we want to use for our server notifications and our Let's Encrypt emails so that we get our SSL certificates. But basically what this is doing is it's using our other open source project called server-side.php, which are PHP images that are optimized for running WordPress and Laravel. So we're using those images to install all of our dependencies because when we start with Docker and we ship with Docker into production, we end up with 100% replication across the entire environment. So we'll ask you questions and if you need any sort of extensions, we come with a good default list of them. We can do task scheduling. Let's do Horizon for our queue management. And let's use Reverb for our WebSockets. We'll use Yarn, let's use Postgres, and we will show you how to deploy through GitHub Actions so that we can just push up and GitHub Actions will automatically build and deploy without any downtime. So this is going to go through its install process. It only takes about a minute or so. and then we will show you how to bring up the development environment. All right, cool. So we have our project created. Let's open this up in our cursor window and let's take a look at what's going on with our application structure. So looking on the left, it's clearly a Laravel application. There's a few things that have been added. So here's all of our Docker configurations. Here's our base Docker Compose file. And then we have what are called our environment files that are extended off the base file. So when I run something, let's open up a new terminal and do spin up. What this is doing is it's using Docker Compose to extend what's going on from our base file. So this is where we can set certain things, like with traffic, we might want to use our laravel.dev.test for our local environment. There might be some other things in Node. We want to use MailPit. But what's nice is when you look at your Docker Compose, you can see here's traffic version 3.1. Here's Redis 7.4, things like that. Everything is centrally located. So when I save this and commit this and push this up, it will make the update across everybody's machine. So there's no decentralized management. Everything is centralized in our repository as our single source of truth. Now, accessing something like this is very easy. We can just go to laravel.dev.test. Here's my development environment. So very easy to get up and running. Now let's take this up to the next level. Let's focus on the GitHub Actions and getting this set up so that I can easily just push up my code and it will just deploy it for me. So the first step that we want to do is pick a host. So I'm just going to go to Hetzner and I'm going to get signed in. Now this will bring me into my project in Hetzner and I can just go to security and API tokens and generate a new API token. So we'll just call this spin and let's assign that read and write. And don't worry, I will delete this token before I publish this video. But we're just going to grab this token and we have what's called the spin.yaml file. This is where we have our entire source of truth of where we have users, we have our providers, we have our servers, and then we have what are called our hardware profiles. So if I look at our providers, you can see that we already provide Hetzner. Now we have DigitalOcean, Hetzner, and Vulture. We're just going to drop down to here. We're going to uncomment this and we're going to paste this in. And what this does is this works kind of like an ENV file. We can have our secrets, we can encrypt this if we want, but we're just going to put this API key here and it's going to stay on my machine. Now for configuring other users, let's just go up here and then we're going to change this username to J. We'll put in the name of J Rogers. And then let's grab, if I just quickly swing over and I just cat out the elements of my public key and make sure I can put that to what's called PB copy, I can pipe that out. So it's nice and easy for me to just drop in, paste my public key in and save that for my project. Now we have our server user ready. We have our provider ready. Now we just need to figure out what we want to use for our actual server. So if I uncomment this, we can call this, we'll call this production web. And then this is going to have the environment of production. You can drop down and configure as many environments that you'd like, but we give you a really nice default of what are called hardware profiles. And you can see we have different providers down here. And this is going to deploy this in Hetzner's US East data center with their CPX11 plan, which is, I think it's like 2 core, 2 gig, and it's only a few bucks a month. And then we're going to deploy this with Ubuntu 24.04 and we're going to enable backups on it. So we have that set by default. And all I need to do is if we just bring up our terminal, we'll get out of our spin up. So we'll bring our container environment down and we just need to run spin provision. Now, this is the cool thing about spin. It's using Ansible. You don't need to know how to use Ansible. If you can configure this YAML file, you'll know how to use Ansible. So what we're doing is we're talking to the Hetzner API. We're going to create the server. It's going to add my SSH key to Hetzner, allow me to connect in, and Spin will automatically take care of the setup of the server for us. Now, this does take a minute or two to run. There's a lot going on. We're creating a server, we're updating the server, we're provisioning the server. But what's nice is Spin will call back to our Spin YAML file and add this. So now, once we run through this provision process, we really don't need to run this process again until we add another server. Now, if you wanted to provide your own server, you don't need to set your API key. You just come in, set your server name, set your address, your environment, and you can delete the hardware profile. And then we will just provision straight to this server IP address so that you can use any host in the world. While that process is running, let's just minimize this for now. And we're going to get our production environment prepared. So what we'll need to do is we're just going to rename this env to env.production. And this will be our file that we will use for our production environment. Now you can see cursors are automatically recommending, hey, change this to production. Make sure you set app debug to false. That's like a Laravel thing. And now we need to come up with an app URL. So I'm just going to swing over to Cloudflare. If we get signed in, I should be able to go to my ssudemo.com. And let's call this Laravel. And then I need that IP address. So we're going to do an A record so that the Laravel record points to an IP. And if I just go to my spin YAML file, copy that and bring this over. And then the other thing with Cloudflare is I'm going to turn that proxy off. That could cause issues for some people that are getting started. I'm just going to press save. So I can go back to my env.production and we can do laravel.ssudemo.com and save that. Now there's a few other things that we have in our docs that you should consider changing. You know, there's things of like the database passwords and things like that. You should definitely change that information and make it unique across your environment. But we can also, since we're using Reverb, let's do reverb.ssudemo.com and we can go back to our spin YAML and let's add that other record of A, paste, oh, whoops, we want to do reverb here and have our IP address. I'm going to turn the proxy off so that we will have reverb.ssudemo.com points to the address that we have from Hessner. I'm just going to press save on that. So those are the only two DNS entries that I need to make. But other than that, this env production file is ready to be used in production. Now we can open up our terminal. We can see that our server is still provisioning. It'll just take it a minute. And what I'm going to do is create a GitHub repository from my command line. So we have this empty Git repository, but we need to basically add a remote. So since we have this brand new project, we need a new repo. So we're going to do a spin gh repo create. And what this will do is this is using another open source image of ours that runs the GitHub CLI through Docker securely on my machine. So I just want to push an existing local repository to GitHub. We're going to use this local app repository. We'll call this, my Laravel app. Type that in. We'll put this under my personal account. And we will set this to private. So this does work with GitHub free private repositories. That's another improvement with Spin 3. And we're going to use these remotes. And that's everything that we want to use. Now, before we push this up, so we have the repository created. If I click on this, you can see that I have an empty repository with nothing in it. But what we need to do is populate our GitHub Actions secrets. And that's going to be based off of our env production file. So now that I have a repository, I can just clear this out. Let's do spin configure gha production. So what this is doing is this is connecting to GitHub Actions and it's creating an SSH deployment key. It's taking our local environment variable file from our production file and uploading that. And then it's setting some information about the server that we just deployed. So looking at this, okay, so we have our authorized key set, we have production, SSH remote host name, we have a private key that's generated for us that's kept in our conf CI folder. All these variables are kept here. So I can see like with authorized keys, if it's taking my user from my spin YAML and uploading that to GitHub Actions. that's super helpful for me to see what GitHub Actions has, and now I'm ready to use that for my deployments. Now, if we look back at our server, you can see that this process took about 4 minutes to complete, which isn't too bad considering how long that would take if you were to do that by hand. And now we're ready for deployment. So all I need to do is I need to just drop in here and just do initial commit. And I'm now ready to publish my branch and push this up. If I switch back to my GitHub Actions, we can refresh this, see that all of our secrets are now in here, and I can go over to GitHub Actions, and I now see that my GitHub Actions is now building my Docker image, which will use the same file that I have here. So we have this Dockerfile PHP, and it's using the same source of truth of what I'm using in my local development. So this will only take a minute or so to assemble itself, and then we'll check in on it from the deployment. Cool, so everything's now deployed. Now I should be able to switch over to my production file. I'm going to click on laravel.ssudemo.com, and this application is live. It's accessible to the world. So this only took us a few minutes to set up. If we swing over, let's just go to our welcome. Let me just get rid of all this. Let's just put in hello world and just add hello world in there and commit that. You can see if I switch back to my GitHub Actions, this thing's just going to start repeating the process of updating my application, getting it deployed, and it's doing it without any downtime. And I'm running this server. If I look back at Hetzner and I look at my account on how much this server is costing me, this server should be right around the $5 USD cost, which is very inexpensive for anybody to run. And not only are we running this inexpensively, we're getting a lot of the power of Laravel, being able to run these advanced services such as Horizon, Reverb. We have the task scheduler. Everything's all made available, and we can dramatically reduce the friction that it takes to ship an application and test an idea out. Now, the only other thing would be to show you TablePlus, which would, if we create our connection, we can choose our PostgreSQL. We can call this spin, and we're going to do the host of Postgres. We can use the default port. If we grab our ENV production, we look at what our database was provisioned with. So we're going to use the username of Postgres, the password of Postgres password, and we'll do the Laravel database name. And we're going to make a secure connection over SSH. So if I just swing over to my spin.yaml file, grab the IP address of my server, and we're running a special tunnel service for you. This is yet another open source image that we wrote, which we can securely expose SSH that will get us connected to our Postgres server. And then we're just going to use the username of tunnel, use my SSH key. If I press test, it's going to ask us, hey, are you sure you want to connect? And once I press connect, everything loads up here. You can see that the migrations have automatically run, and I can start manipulating data. So you can see that spin is very complete. We've put a ton of time. We've brought in a ton of user feedback. We're very excited about spin version 3. Spin is completely open source. We have an open source template for Laravel that will do the SQLite. Our Laravel Pro template will do all these other advanced features. Anything that we earn from Laravel Pro is just heavily reinvested back into all of these open source projects that we put into a collection called Spin. So we hope you're seeing the value in the work that our community has put together. We're very grateful for everybody that we've met. We'd love to have you join our community. We're on Discord. You can find us at serversideup.net. If you would like, subscribe, share this video, whatever platform that you're viewing this on, that would help us out greatly. But we're so looking forward to the future of Spin. This doesn't even cover all the features that are now available. We just wanted to give you the most exciting features today. Stay tuned for future updates as we create more content and educate others on how to self-host their applications. Thanks for watching, and we'll keep you posted on the next one. Thanks.